guys, I'm Randall.
That's JJ
from GotTrained.com. What we're going to do is we're going to cover an ankle lock variation that you can use when you are defending the headlock from behind while on the ground. Now, the general rule is if the person behind, in this case JJ, when he puts his legs around, he's supposed to keep his feet uncrossed. That's standard Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu 101. You don't cross your ankles because if the ankles get crossed, you're very vulnerable to getting ankle lock. Bad shit happens. So that's what we're going to cover. If this is available, you can ankle lock them. All right, so first thing to keep in mind is that if you get really good at the basic defense, you can still make it work even if the bad guy's ankles are crossed. So for example, what kind of side should he do? He's got his ankles crossed here. He's going for the choke. I can still make the basic defense work, all right? So that's not necessarily an issue. However, why not throw in the ankle lock? Because if you do it, you will cause instant damage on the attacker. Now, let's turn us straight on again, please. Part of the reason why this is not in the standard Kramgat curriculum, because it is a little complicated. It's hard to remember which foot to put on top, blah, 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 etc. So it kind of violates that principle of making techniques simple and easy to do under stress. However, if you're willing to put in the time and practice this, once you get good at it, the results are instant gratification. You can cause a lot of damage on the attacker's ankles, their knee, or both. So once you learn this, you recognize somebody putting their ankles crossed like this, if they're an inexperienced fighter, you'll take advantage of it every single time. I love this move because people squeal before they tap. So here's the details to this. While I'm defending and plucking and doing whatever, if I notice that his ankles are crossed, what I do is I assess which foot is on top. So in this case, his right foot's on top, but I don't think of it in terms of left or right foot. What I do is I think of his top foot is on my left side. So if it's on my left side, I take my left foot, I'm going to put my side of my ankle right here, I'm going to kind of put it on the side of his foot where the ball of the foot is, a little bit above the toes here. So if his ball of the foot is right here, his toes are here, this is kind of the area I focus on the side. I put my side of the ankle right there. Now what I do with the other foot is I put that foot on top like I'm crossing my ankles, or when you get more advanced, you can even do a figure four. I suggest when you first learn it, just cross your ankles like this. It's a little bit easier to learn. I found beginners have more success with this, and then they can try the figure four version, which is technically a little bit better, a little bit tighter, but harder to learn. And then from here, all I'm going to be doing is driving down on his foot, and what happens is when I drive down on his foot right here, it ends up twisting his ankle like this, which will either create pressure on his ankle or his knee, depending on where he's more stiff. Basically, it's doing that. So here, his foot's on this side. This one's here, this one's on top, and I press down. Now, an issue that might come up is, notice when I press down, the ground is in the way. I press down, there's nothing there. So there's two solutions to that. One is, before I even go for the ankle lock, while I'm defending my neck and protecting myself, I will lean back first, because when I lean back and drive into him, not only does it get me in position to do the regular defense, but watch how much space it creates between his feet and the ground. Now, when I see this, I can put the foot on top, then the other one on top. And if I drive into him, drive my hips up, there'll be sufficient space to make that work. So that's the first solution if you run out of space. The other solution is to tilt to the side, like this. So once again, I'm defending myself, protecting my neck. If I try to do this move here, I'm running out of real estate. I turn to the side, doesn't matter which side. So now there's no space going this direction. I'll drive this way, drive my hips forward. I'm not going to run out of real estate at all. Alright, so I'm going to do that one again, and the other variation I'm going to use is the figure four instead of the ankle cross variation. So if you get good at that one, once I master this and tilt to the side, I have an option of figure four in the legs. Yeah. And doing the same technique. So I actually like that one better in the long run because it's a more secure grip. But like I said, don't try that one out. Try the ankle cross version because it's a little bit easier to learn. And the biggest mistake beginners make is they put the pressure on the top of the foot, and that just bends the foot straight back, forward and back, which doesn't work as well. It's got to be right here. Here's the ball of the foot on the side this way, and you've got to get this twisting motion like that. So that's the key. And as you're doing this, make sure you're still plucking, chin down, defending the choke. You shouldn't be screwing around with your hands down here because then you're going to get choked out while you're screwing around with that or getting beat up and punching the head or whatever. So your hands need to be up while you're defending yourself. If you're not very flexible, you still keep one hand up to protect yourself. So for example, maybe if he's got the headlock on or a choke of any kind, I'm going to be fighting with one hand. And if I'm a little too stiff, I can take one hand and feed feed my leg up there and do the same over here. If you're too flexible, then don't use two hands. You always have one hand and another up, always to protect yourself. But ideally, I would prefer to just use my feet so I'm still protecting myself up here. So those are that's the ankle lock version. Like I said, it's kind of hard to learn, but once you get it, it's like it's just a miracle technique. It works instantly. Like I said, it's one of these moves that people will squeal before they tap. So when you practice this on your train partner, make sure you do it slow, be careful with it so there's no injuries. People get their knees hurt all the time or their ankles injured all the time if people aren't applying this technique slowly and carefully. Anyways, this is the basic ankle lock variation. Try this out, and in a real fight, you would do this, cause injury to the person, drive into them, do the regular defense, and get up just like you normally would. So this is a nice addition to your basic defense. Okay, try it out, guys, and see how it goes for you. Thank you.